This one is located near a small city called Vila Nova Foscoa, and it's located in Upper Douro. So Douro is subdivided in three subregions, and we are here at Upper Douro. It's the subregion more close to Spain. My name is Francisco Lazabal, and I'm working here at Valmião. I'm running this company, but I'm also the winemaker. So we started in 1999. Our top wine is named Quinta de Valmião. It's the name of the property too. We never made more than 30,000 bottles of this wine. It came every year from the same vineyards. And we start also that year with Meandro. It means meander of the river because we are surrounded by the river. We have lots of wild boars here in our property. And our logo is a wild boar, a tree, and three hearts. And of course, it's something that came from a long time, but I have another explanation. My father used this explanation, is that the three hearts are my sister, my brother, and me. The tree is my mother, and the wild boar is my father.
My name is Francisco Xavier Olazabal. It's a Basque name, but I was born in Oporto. My mother was Portuguese. My father was great-grandson of António Adelaide Ferreira, better known in Portugal as the Ferreirinha. She was one of the most important figures in northern Portugal and in Portugal during the 19th century. Last part of her life, she decided to invest in the western part of the Douro region, which was a remote part of the country. And in fact, this was the last big dream and the last big project of her life. When the project was completed, 8 years later, in 1985, she only survived to 1 year. She died in 1996. It was only in 1994 that I became the only owner. It was one of the happiest days of my life when I bought about 60% of the Quinta.
We started with a French approach to the business, only two wines. Recently, we add to our portfolio two more wines, or three more wines, from single vineyards and single grape varieties. That's quite recent, we started only 3 years ago, but small quantities just to show to people like our wines how the different terroirs and different grapes behave here at our property.
Quality, in fact, all resides in the details. The enormous amount of details involved in producing grapes and then making wine from these grapes.
So we have all these grape varieties planted in schist soils, granite soils and alluvial soils, you know, so it's very interesting for me to make lots of different wines from different types of soils and different grape varieties. You can imagine the combinations you can make here.
You can invent attractive things, but to have consistency, to have character, to be able to understand what the land gives you, it's a very important factor of success. I had the fortune of asking help to one of my wife's uncle, José Rosas, and he told me in a very honest way, well, I don't have a scientific proven theory about that, but have a feeling, is that in your type of soil, in your type of climate, I think that you should try Touriga Nacional. And this was a very important move, because Touriga Nacional proved to be the backbone of my wines. Valmião was always about 50 to 70% of Touriga Nacional.
Touriga Nacional gives the freshness and the floral component of the wine, and you can feel that.
The nose is more on the type of some types of roses. It's a fragrant, intense nose, and freshness, which is very important in this type of climate, the hot climate.
And Tinta Roriz, which is a grape variety some people don't like, but I like it because it's very different from Touriga Franca and Tinta Roriz, gives a different type of tannins. They are more present, and also the aromatics of the Tinta Roriz are more like Asian spices. So this combination of these three grape varieties, I think it works very well here.
The use of wood also is something that we start doing in a sort of tentative way. We start by having Quinta de Valmião 100% matured in new French oak barriques. Now we are using less new, more used barriques, because we think that perhaps it's more balanced to do that.
Oh, no, of course, port wine. We started with vintage port. Our first vintage port, it was in the year 2000. And we are keeping every year some stock of port wine to make in the future, maybe 10, 20 years old, and also Colheitas. We sell for more than 35 countries. Of course, there are some markets are more interesting for us. First, the Portuguese market is around 40% of our sales. But then we have a very good markets like United States and Brazil and Germany. These more important markets. But we like to sell also for specialized agents all over the world that recognize our wine and then can introduce Portuguese wine to the consumers, because most of the people don't know anything about Portuguese wines.
Having people from Romania that are interested in Portuguese wines is quite a privilege. It's very important to be a classic wine. Very important. I mean that we can produce many wines with great success, but to build a classic reputation is very difficult, takes time. Some people think that Torrigo Nacional looks like some film stars that are very sexy, but they have no brains behind it.